Good morning to all of you here and wherever you are. We are thankful for the privilege of being able to worship together. We are at Ottawa First United Methodist Church, live streaming on Facebook and broadcasting on KOFO radio station. We pray that you will be fulfilled through worshiping with us. At this time, we have some announcements.
Good morning. We wrapped up our baby bottle drive, and unfortunately the kids are busy preparing something else for you here in a little bit, so I'm your deliverer of the message this morning. But we collected over $362 from the baby bottle drive, so I just want you to give yourselves a round of applause. Those donations will go to Life Care Center here in Ottawa, so we are so blessed for all of your help. And then next week we have an Easter egg hunt that we are going to do with the kids, and it's going to be a little non-traditional. We're going to pair the kids up, and they're going to go find some eggs that have clues in them that relate to Jesus's last days, and they're going to have to solve the clue in order to get their treat. So if you have any young kids that you bring with you next week, I will come up at the beginning and grab them, and we will do this unique Easter egg hunt. And thank you for all of those who donated items for that. I know the kids are very excited. So thank you for your continued support.
And thank you for all the things, great things you come up with to share with our children. The church board is announcing the reopening of our church building as of April 1st. The new safe distancing will be employed with seating in every other row, and songbooks will be returned to the pews. Masks will be required for everyone since we are all at different stages with our vaccines or not. The pastor and liturgist may remove their masks for speaking from the podiums. We will continue live streaming the services on Facebook indefinitely and broadcasting as usual on KOFO radio. We hope that by being careful, this will be a good and healthy decision for everyone. Now bow with me, please. Lord, we gather together in one heart, even if we're not all in one place to worship you, and to lift those up who have special needs for their health conditions and situations. You are all knowing, and we trust you, and pray that your word will be received and that people will understand that the strength comes from you for our bodies and for our souls. We come to praise you, and we ask you for your blessings on all those who hear your word, and thank you for your messengers. Be with Pastor Jay and the worship leaders as they lead us in this time of worship. To God be the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. Good morning. I'm Carolyn Elder, your liturgist this morning. You may remain seated for this first reading. Hear from the Gospel according to Mark 11, verses 1 through 11, how our Lord entered Jerusalem. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here immediately.' They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing untying the colt?' They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. They brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, 'Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven.' Then he entered Jerusalem and went to the temple. And when he looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. Would you please stand for the call to worship? Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please remain standing for the opening songs.
We'll be singing 278, Hosanna, loud Hosanna, and sing it like you are right in front of the colt.
Loud, triumphant songs break.
Sounds like we left the country to celebrate elsewhere. Awesome. Would you join with me, please, in the opening prayer? Almighty God, on this day your Son, Jesus Christ, entered the holy city of Jerusalem and was proclaimed king by those who spread their garments and palm branches along the way. Let those branches be for us signs of his victory, and grant that we who bear them in his name may ever hail him as our Lord and follow him in the way that leads to life. In his name we pray.
We'll be singing this morning, I Believe in a Hill Called Mount Calvary.
I believe on heaven.
Please stand as you are able for the reading of the scripture. This morning's scripture comes from Mark 14, verses 32 to 42. Jesus prays in Gethsemane. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took with him Peter and James and John and began to be distressed and agitated. As he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake." And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said, "Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want." He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, "Simon, why are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough, the hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated.
Today is Palm Sunday of 2021. Palm Sunday commemorates the entrance of Jesus Christ into Jerusalem. Jesus Christ rode on a donkey, and the celebrating people laid down their cloaks and small branches of trees in front of him, singing part of Psalms chapter 118, 25, verse 26. "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord." The donkey symbolized peace, unlike the horse, which is an animal of war. Jesus came to us as a Prince of Peace, not as a mighty conqueror. However, the people of Jerusalem who had welcomed him with praises of Hosanna turned over their attitude and shouted, "Crucify him," on Friday morning. We call this week Passion Week. Jesus was arrested on Thursday night, and the trial began on Friday morning. He was given the death sentence by Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died around 3 p.m. on Friday. From his arrest to his burial, just the entire process of Jesus' execution was done within 24 hours. However, Jesus Christ resurrected on Sunday early in the morning. Today's scripture is about Jesus' prayer at Gethsemane before he was arrested. The story of Jesus' passion begins with his prayer at Gethsemane. This prayer shows us how to pray when we face hardships in our lives. Jesus' prayer at Gethsemane is a good model for truthful prayer. And this morning I will introduce this truthful prayer, and we will think about this from today's scripture. After the Last Supper, Jesus went to Gethsemane with Peter, James, and John to pray. He knew what would happen to him. So he said to them in verse 34, I am deeply grieved even to death. Remain here and keep awake. They went up to Mount Olive. That is another name of Garden of Gethsemane. He prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He prayed at Gethsemane overnight to figure out God's plan. A truthful prayer is not asking for what we want, but what God wants. In verse 36, Jesus prayed, Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want. Jesus did not want to die like a normal person, but he prayed that God's will was the priority that needed to be done. This is a truthful prayer. We need to ask God not about what we want, but about what God wants. We should ask God to help us know God's will. When we know God's will, we can overcome our fear by the power of God. To know God's will, we need wisdom from God. God is always listening to our prayers, and he always responds us. We believe in God's providence. God is with us, and he knows everything what we need. However, if we don't have wisdom from God, we won't recognize God's answer, even though he has responded already. As children of God, we must believe that God is taking care of his children. We should trust God and believe in God's abiding grace when we face troubles on our spiritual journey. Jesus took up his cross and crucified after praying at Gethsemane. When we have faith that God is with us, we can accomplish our mission from God. We must know God's will as children of God. Sometimes we don't want to follow God's direction because that is hard for us. Many Christians pray for something good for themselves always. They don't want to know God's will. However, as sincere Christians, we should pray truthful prayer. A truthful prayer is seeking to God's will. So in this Passion Week, let us practice praying a truthful prayer. To pray a truthful prayer, we should be strengthened by God. Praying is not an easy task. If we are weak, it's more harder. In Luke chapter 22, verse 43 and 44, this is another translation of the Gethsemane prayer. It describes Jesus' prayer. Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground. Jesus prayed all night with such intensity that his sweat turned to drops of blood. But his disciples couldn't pray because they were not earnest In verse 37 and 38, Jesus said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Jesus called his disciples to pray with him. However, his disciples didn't recognize what Jesus would face in the morning. So they slept. And once more he came, found them sleeping. And they did not know what to say to him. When Jesus came to his disciples a third time, his disciples were still sleeping. Satan's temptations are always around us. In 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8, it says, "Discipline yourselves, keep alert. Like a roaring lion, your adversary, the devil, prowls around, looking for someone to devour." As disciples of Jesus, we should stay awake and pray that we may not come into a time of trial when we are living in this world. We need strength from God to pray continually. Jesus prayed 3 times for the same thing. However, many people said a prayer and pray a few times before giving up because it doesn't seem to come true. Praying till it is answered by God is a truthful prayer. Even though Jesus is Son of God, he prayed 3 times at Gethsemane. As we know, Elijah killed 450 prophets of Baal on Mount Carmel. After he killed the Baal's prophet, he prayed to God for rain. In 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 33 and 44, it says, "He said to his servant, 'Go up now, look toward the sea.' He went up and looked and said, 'There is nothing.' Then he said, 'Go again 7 times. At the 7th time, he said, 'Look, a little cloud no bigger than a person's hand is rising out of the sea.'" Elijah prayed 7 times the same prayer request. As children of God, we should pray without ceasing by the strength from God. When we are strengthened by God, we can be prayer warriors. We should pray for the people who need God. Whenever we recognize a prayer request, pray for them without hesitation, because God wants us to pray for them. We share joys and concerns every Sunday before worship service. This time is not an announcement time. Remember prayer request and pray for them whenever you remember in the name of Jesus Christ. We should pray for one another and ask for God's strength. As disciples of Jesus, we should pray a truthful prayer. After praying at Gethsemane, Jesus was ready to face his destiny. In verse 41 and 42, it says, "He came a 3rd time and said to them, Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up. Let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand. When Jesus finished his prayer, he had confidence that God listened to his prayer. Jesus was ready to take cross with this confidence. We should have faith that God is always listening to our prayer. When we have this faith, it brings peace to our minds, and we can do anything in God. This is the power of a truthful prayer. We can communicate with God through prayer, and we are strengthened by God through a truthful prayer. Prayer brings power and deepens our relationship with God. Therefore, we should have our own place to pray, like Gethsemane for Jesus. One of the most respected U.S. President Abraham Lincoln was a person of prayer. He believed that it was impossible to find a way to solve a problem with a person's wisdom. Whenever he faced problems, he prayed first at his room. Even though he had many advisors next to him, he prayed to God before he made a final decision. This morning we thought about Jesus' prayer at Gethsemane. Jesus was able to take his cross and accomplish his mission because of his truthful prayer. Let us make our own Gethsemane and communicate with God in our daily lives. When we practice praying a truthful prayer, we will recognize God's answer through wisdom from God, and we will be strengthened by God. Let us pray. Dear our beloved God, we thank you for being with us. We've realized that Jesus had gained the power to overcome the fear of the crucifixion and death through his prayer at Gethsemane. Help us to pray to you with all our heart and with all our sincerity. Lead us so that we can experience your almighty power. Help us learn about the truthful prayer so we can have a good relationship with you. Lord, be with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. Our Heavenly Father, you have given your very best to us. Help us to bring our best to you. Help us to offer to you the best of our time, the best of our thought, and the best of our talent. Lord, bless them and meet the needs of a lost and perished world. Lord, be with us and take us and use us for your kingdom. I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Stay standing for our final hymn, Go to Dark That Gethsemane.
Go in peace with the power of truthful prayer. Go ready to proclaim with your lives that Jesus is Lord and Savior. Go to offer God's love and peace to all who you meet. Now the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.